Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to a safety meeting gameplay series. Today, we are continuing our survival in Rising World. There's our little moose buddies over there. I was starting to get a little bit worried about them. So let's get ourselves up to speed a little bit here. It's been a minute since the last episode, and that was because my son and I, we started a new series on a different game, and literally the second we hit record, the microphone kind of broke on us. So I ended up having to go out and get a new one. And turns out the settings were a lot different than the microphone that I used to have. But it was a blessing in disguise because this one is much better. So my apologies if there's anything weird in the audio right now because I'm still trying to tweak some of the settings. So I just wanted to let you know real fast that if there is something weird in the audio that I'll be fixing it kind of as we go along. So, all right, back to our world here. I'll stop wandering around and getting you dizzy here. Now, I put it up for discussion on what everybody thought of this little basic cabin that we've got going on so far. And it seems like everything was positive reactions. One thing, somebody mentioned that there might be too much of a contrast between this trim and the light planks here. And I think I 100% agree with that. What I was trying to go for is just to match the look of the trees and stuff, but I think that's just too much of a contrast there. So we're going to play around a little bit and see what the best color, maybe like a little bit of a, some kind of a redwood or something I think might look nice. And then the other thing, now if I was reading the suggestion right, we were talking about the way that the windows are set up. So the way that we had it set before is the height of the window was 2 blocks wide. And I got a suggestion of using a half slab in here. So I think what I'm going to do, we've got the top of our doorway right here. I want the top of the doorway to match the top of the windows. So I think, let's try this out. Instead of putting a full block right here, because it blocks quite a bit of our view, we're going to do a half slab. And what that's going to do is just kind of set the proportions a little bit more correctly. And it'll open up the view. And I think just overall, it'll make the whole thing look tons better. So we go into our wood planks, and we want to find block 97 right there. Oh, I don't have any wood on me right now, so I'm going to have to go chop some trees. Either that or I left it in the chest, I'm not sure. But you can see that we've got these right arrow keys, right and left. This actually changes the shape of the block that we can use. So here's our half slab right here, but we've got tons of other stuff that you can do. You can do pillars and half pillars. Here's some 45 degree angled blocks. Can make little half pipes if you're a skateboarder. And you can do all sorts of cool decorative trims and things like that. There's your stairs and all sorts of really, really neat combinations of stuff that you can do. But that's getting into a whole nother thing there with all the different combos of what you can do. This is all we need right here is just a nice simple half slab. So here is the plan. I gotta move those benches over here too now that we have the footprint of the house. Maybe we'll put the benches... Ooh, a fly just buzzed my head. Maybe we'll put the benches back here. It's like we almost got some ripe tomatoes going on. No, we don't have to venture so far when we need food. Ooh, it sounds like we got a storm blowing in. See, I don't really want to chop down anything nearby here. And that bear is still hanging out. Man. That guy's just going to guard that whole forest right there. So we're going to come up and around over here, I guess. Oh, hello. We have a partially buried moose over here. Here, do you need a hand? Last time we did this, he got all upset, so maybe he'll leave. Don't leave the property, though. I want you still here. Oh, there's our resident moose right there guarding the house. Awesome. I guess we'll just come over here. We can clear out a little bit of this. Now, the one thing that I have been doing is gathering the saplings. I haven't replanted any just yet, because I don't know where I'm going to do the planting. I don't want to cover up all of my view with trees. So we're going to figure out just exactly what we've got going on. So one of the things that I'm really looking forward to, and I think it's supposed to be out shortly, is the character model update. We'll actually have a hand attached to this axe. I guess we're going to have male and female characters and able to choose some of their attributes and clothing and things like that. I'm not exactly sure what all is entailed in that update, but From what I understand, though, even before that... Here, come here, you. Man, these things are falling in terrible spots. Put that one in a minute. In the next update, I guess we're supposed to get dungeons, and the dungeons are going to have some baddies in there that want to hurt us. One of the other things, too, and I don't know if this was just something that somebody in the forum was just talking about and hoping was going to be in it, or if it actually is, but it kind of sounded like there might be some NPC characters running around the topside world as well, and not all of them are going to be good. So I'm not exactly sure what the story is on that, so I don't want to be passing rumors or anything like that that aren't true, so I'm going to make sure I let you know that. That's just what I read. I'm not exactly positive. So if anybody does know anything about that, let me know. I'd like to know the update on that. Oh, one thing, speaking of updates, too, that I want to mention. I thought it was pretty funny because I don't know if it was in the last episode or the one before that when I was talking about a furnace. And I was thinking to myself, well, not to myself, I did it out loud, but I was thinking, I wonder if I should build two furnaces. And there is somebody that, they were just absolutely beside themselves that I forgot that there's a wide mouth furnace. It's got the extra capacity. I thought it was pretty funny, the reaction when they saw that I wasn't using the wide mouth furnace. I just totally forgot about it. So in one of the last updates, we got a giant furnace, and I keep forgetting about the stinking thing. So maybe in a little bit, we'll just get rid of the furnace that we got, and we'll replace it with the wide mouth one and see what that thing is all about. I guess it's got like double the capacity or something like that. I've seen the photos of it. I honestly just, I always make a regular, get over here. I always just end up making the regular furnace. Where the heck did that tree even go? Man, that thing went far. Okay, so what do we got here? We got 40 logs. This should give us a good head start on this house. Wherever the heck that's at. Ah, I was going the right way. Definitely need to smooth out some trails through here. That actually might not be a bad idea right through here. Because this seems to be kind of the main thoroughfare that I've been using. So we have another project on the agenda. What do we got here? We are just gonna steal you and then see what you are. Looks like a potato sapling. Cool. Let's go plant that real fast. I try to plant everything as soon as I get it. That way, obviously, the faster we plant it, the quicker we can eat it. There we go. Our block 97. Now, what do we want to use for the trim? Well, let's get this half slab made anyway. All right, so that makes 6 no matter what. So let's see what this is going to do for us real quick. So there's our half slab. Yeah, that's much better. Yeah, that's going to open up the window a lot. So let's get a floor put in here. Let's make that our first priority, is some kind of a floor. This is actually the block that I was originally thinking about using for the walls, but I just didn't like the color. It has too much of a gray tone. It's like a warm gray, and I didn't like that. Let's see for the floor. Let's see what this might look like for the floor. Remember, I'm not trying to go for anything clean. I want this to be nice and rugged. I mean, it's a cabin in the woods, so. All right, that gives us a tiny contrast between the walls and the floor. Yeah, I think that's going to work. And then we're going to trim this all out and everything. I mean, it's a basic cabin, but I'm still going to do some trim and some of the decorative stuff like that. We don't want it to be boring. I mean, look at this area. It's gorgeous. Still want to make the cabin look good. All right, I have absolutely no idea how many of these I'm actually going to need. Probably a heck of a lot more than I just made. Yeah, I think this is going to look good. Normally I put in a really dark floor, something that has a huge contrasting color to it, but I think that would kind of ruin it here. I want to be far from high tech. Yeah, we need to make a ton more. I didn't use all the logs already, did I? Oh, cool. Got a whole nother stack there. All right, with a few left over. So, I think that's going to look good. Now, let me show you real fast what I was talking about with that window. Let me go grab some more wood real fast. I'll be right back. Oh, dang. I guess he doesn't want me to leave. You know, one thing I can tell you, there are no flat areas around here. I don't even know where the other one went. Oh, geez, they're way down there. Are you serious? All right. Well, I think probably what we should do is go sleep. Because I can't see a darn thing anymore. Forgot how quickly it gets dark. I'm gonna run up on a bear, you know I'm gonna. Or the moose is just gonna scare the crap out of me. Alright, let's go sleep real fast. We'll try this again. Maybe we'll do some kind of strategy. Jeez. Okay, that's good enough for right now. So, here we get to go into our saw bench and get into some of these construction items. So now the window frames, now here's our different options. We can do, there's A, this is just your basic frame. There's B, C, and D. My favorite is always C. I don't know why, I just like having that little offset right there. And use our right arrow key to change. Now let's see, that might be the color that I end up going with for the trim. Let's try it with one of the windows and just see. All right, so what we want to do for the window frames, you can see that this automatically just kind of snaps them in. But because we used a half slab, it doesn't fit. I will show you what we need to do for that. Now there's an easy way to adjust this. Now what we want to do here, I'm going to put this pretty much just right in the middle. I'm not getting high tech or anything like that here. And eventually we're going to put kind of a little bit of a windowsill down to block this light plank. But for right now, let's just get this thing in. I'll show you how to get them to expand to the size of your windowsill. Now, put this right, I mean, it doesn't matter where you want to put it. You can even hang it just a little bit off the edge if you want, which actually isn't a bad idea. One of the things that we can do is actually put one of these on the outside and then take the window frame A that doesn't have the little crossbars in it, and you can put that, stack three of them right next to each other, and you'll actually have a full windowsill. So actually, let's do that. I'll show you what the heck I'm talking about here. Let's come out here. Now, I'm going to have this hang out just a tiny little bit. So we're going to start it right here. Now, what I want to do is press right control, and that freezes it in place. Now, I can actually step back and look, and it hasn't been placed yet. Prepare yourself for just a quick tutorial here. So if you don't want a tutorial, scan about 2 minutes ahead. Now, using my arrow keys, and this is all going to be dependent on which direction you're facing, so you're just going to have to play around with the direction of the keys. Now, if I use my left and right arrow keys, you can see I'm actually manipulating where this is going position-wise. So we're going to hang it out about that far. Now, if I come back out here, we're still not fitting right there. So what I want to do now is hold down left shift and up arrow key. Now, you can see we just expanded the height of this window frame. Now we want to use page up and page down. The arrow keys are going to move you forward, back, left, and right. Page up and page down will actually move you up and down. So We're going to come up, and we're still not quite in there yet. So shift, arrow up, page up. Here's page down. Let's go shift, arrow up one more time. So now we have a window frame that actually fits our window. So if we come up here, we can just make sure that it's about where we want it. And it's pretty much, yep, it's exactly where we want it. All we have to do to make this final is right click, and it puts it right in place. So now we press control, and it unfreezes our second window frame. And now it's all sized for the windows. We're gonna do control, which is just gonna freeze it. I haven't actually placed it just yet. I'm gonna make sure that it's matching up here. I think it goes a little bit higher. So we're gonna do page up. There we go. So that should match. There we go. Beautiful. All right, so I think that makes a pretty decent start. Here, let's do the same thing with the doorway real fast. And we're gonna go through and we're actually gonna fill all of this stuff in. I'll probably take three more of these window frames without the crossbar. And we'll just stack them side by side and it'll fill up this whole area with one big window frame. And it ends up making it look tons better. So we're gonna do the same thing real fast with the doorway. See, I think we need to make some lumber though. Here, let's make a bunch more lumber. Nope, wrong bench. I do know what I'm doing sometimes, I swear. So this is called a window frame, but you don't have to use all of this stuff for what it's for. So let's see. Let's go ahead and make a few of these, and I'll show you what I'm talking about as far as stacking all of these. So we want to do the same thing now. We are going to place this. Well, place is the wrong word because I'm not actually placing it. We're just putting in the shape right in the general area that we want it. Hit control, right control, and that's going to freeze it in place. Now, the way that the height adjustment works, we might as well use page up right now and just get this about right as close to the center as we can. And then do shift, hold down left shift, and arrow up. Now you can see kind of where I'm going with this. Page down, still not quite in there. Okay, shift and arrow up. Okay, so that's the maxed out length right there. So there's our doorway. Let's see, we'll bring it right there. And then we're gonna do down arrow, should bring it towards me. There's our door frame. I made four of these, I think it was. So let's pull it back. Whoop, wrong button. Let's pull it back just a little bit more. Is it still overhanging? Nope, too much. There we go, we just want a little overhang here. So now what we want to do is right click and that puts it in place. Now don't hit your control button to unfreeze it. Keep this here. Now if we use our down arrow key, there's the second one that we made, and there's the ghost of that one. So we want to make sure they're overlapping just a little bit. Hit right mouse button, and that places that one. And I think we made four of these all together, which wasn't enough, but enough to give you the idea anyway. Yeah, looks like you need at least six in order to fit all the way through there. But that's what I was talking about as far as making a little windowsill or a full-size door jamb. So my apologies for the impromptu tutorial there, but I couldn't do that without telling you exactly what I was doing with all the keystrokes and stuff like that. So, all right. So I think this is what I'm going to do. I believe I like this color. That's Material 71. I think I'm going to go with that. So there's a bunch of stuff that we can do. We can put that little decorative piece down in here, that little plank and things like that. All sorts of stuff. All right, so tell me what you think of that with that color and everything. I think that's the one that I'm going to go for. I think that's got a good contrasting color right there. I'm about to die, so I should probably get some water. Got a few tomatoes left here. I have both of those in the red. That's my problem when I start building. I go into a zone and pay no attention to the fact that I'm actually starving to death. Alright, so here's what I'm going to do. I got all that lumber now. I think I'm just going to make a whole bunch. Well, actually, yeah, we still got a few. I'm going to go through and finish out all of our blocks here. See how far we can get in completing the walls here. So I will be back in just a minute. Alright, that was the last of our blocks. Now, I haven't put any spots for windows yet, because I don't know exactly where they're going to go. But we got the looks of a cabin. It's getting there. We have a square. Let's go on to our little scenic overlook here. Yeah, I think that's going to be alright. I don't mind that. Where's Moose? Come here, Moose. I need your opinion. Moose is gone. Let's see if Moose is still hanging out over here real fast. It's probably Bear hanging out over here. Ooh, hello. Come here, Mr. Moose. Here, I need your opinion. Hey, you. Come here, I need you. He's not listening. I think we made him mad when we stood on his head. Alright, so I think what I'm going to do is just finish off the walls here. I have no idea what I'm going to do for a roof yet. I'm going to finish off the walls, get my windows figured out here, and probably call it good for right now. I think that's a good wrap it up point. I feel like we got a little bit accomplished anyway. Well, I hope it helped you out a little bit by showing you out some of the controls with the window frames and stuff. Now, the cool thing is you can actually do that with anything that's found in that saw bench. Speaking of the benches, I need to move those. Any of these materials in here you can actually do that with. So with your wood planks and your beams, even your glass, the glass panes you can do it with. So the possibilities are pretty much literally endless of what you can actually do as far as building in this game. You could reproduce any existing architecture to the T if you wanted to. And if you want to check out some of the really cool builds that you can do, and I can't take credit for almost any of them, but on my server we have many, many very talented builders. And so on occasion we'll do a server tour episode just to kind of update on what we've got going on and what people are doing. And it's some of the most amazing stuff that I've ever seen. And it's a good way just to get good ideas. That's exactly what I use it for, is I'm lucky I get to actually walk around through the places and get the ideas, but even watching it on video, you'll get tons of cool ideas. I mean, I guarantee any of those server tours, you're going to probably at least 10 times go, wow, I had no idea you could do that. And you'll probably turn off the video and go right into your Rising World game and try some of the stuff out. There's a pretty cool view right there. Yeah, I'm going to have to screenshot it. It sounded so bummed that I was screenshotting it. Huh. All right, so after that gorgeous view, I think we're good for right now. Let's go ahead and do that wrap up. And next time we see you, we'll have some walls and windows, and we'll figure out what we're going to do for a roof. And I think some exploration is in order as well. I think we just got to go run around and see what the rest of this world looks like. And we'll empty our inventory out and just gather wood and resources along the way. I think we need a good resource hunt. So I think that's probably what we'll do. We'll get away from the building for a minute, and we'll just spend an episode exploring. As always, I appreciate everybody for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, please do leave me a like. I really appreciate those as well. And I will see you guys next time for another episode of Survival in Rising World.